Hi there, Kiri here. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to create a class and post assignments in Google Classroom. Okay, to get started, we'll navigate to classroom.google.com. Once you're on the classroom page, to create a class, you're looking for the plus icon in the top right corner. From there, you can click Create Class. Make sure to give your class a name, and the other options are not required. The only one we really need to have is the class name, and then if you feel so inclined, you can add section, subject, and room. Once you have your credentials filled out, you'll click Create, and we'll wait for the program to generate your class. It's automatically going to give you kind of a theme and a color style for your class, and it'll put the title up at the top. So now we have our first Google Classroom here, and that is as easy as it is. That's how you create a class. Now, to get students to join this class, there are two ways to do that. You can give students the class code, and then students would go to classroom.google.com, and in that plus section at the top right corner, they would click join a class, and they would enter your unique class code. The second way to add students to your class is to navigate to the People tab up here in the top center, and you can manually add students by typing in a name or an email here. You can enter in your students one by one that way, or you can provide the whole group that class code. You can also add collaborating teachers the same way by clicking on the add icon here and invite teachers. Now, going back to that home page that's called your stream, here you'll communicate with your class. You can have announcements, your assignments, and any other posts will show up here on the stream. You also have a specific tab for classwork, and you have a specific tab for looking at grades. Once you enter in assignments, they will populate on this screen, and you'll be able to enter in grades for assignments this way, or by clicking on each individual assignment and entering grades one by one there. Let's look back at the classwork tab, because part of this tutorial is also going to show you how to create an assignment. So from our classwork tab, we can see the blue button here in the top left corner for create. Click Create, and you have lots of options here, but for the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to look at the assignment option. You'll give your assignment a title, and instructions you can provide in the space below. Here you have the option to add some resources for your students. You can add a file from your Google Drive, a link to a site or video, a file saved on your computer, or a YouTube link, and these are all options that you can add to enhance or provide resources to help students complete this assignment. This over here, this navigation section to the right, you are selecting which class and section it's for. You can select all students, or you can toggle this switch off and select particular students that need this assignment. You can decide how it will be graded, or you can leave it ungraded. You can select a due date. These are optional features. You can leave it without a due date for now. And the topics are helping you sort your work into different sections. So if you have a particular topic, you would create a topic, and that's kind of an optional feature as well. You have the option to add a rubric, and we can talk about originality reports in a later tutorial. So once you have the basic details down, you can click Assign, and that will immediately send it to your stream and send it out to your students. You can schedule it for a specific time and date to show up for your students, or if you're not ready to assign this just yet, you can save it as a draft, okay? So if I click Assign, it does its magic, and you see it is populated now here on the Classwork tab. We should also see it show up on our classroom stream, okay? As students are turning in work, you can click on the assignment to view who has turned it in and who is still has it assigned but has not turned it in yet. You can see their work here, whether they have turned it in or not. You can check on their progress by clicking on the assignment. You can also click here, because what Google has done is, since you've created this assignment, it has generated a folder in your Google Drive to house all of the assignments. So you can click to open that folder and view assignments all together in one folder instead of here in the Google Classroom platform. So I hope that was helpful. Again, we wanted to show you how to create a class today, and how to add an assignment. Please look for other tutorials on other options for viewing and grading assignments in the future, and best of luck. Thanks for watching.